Welcome. Well, I, for one, never doubted that you'd be back.
Neither did I.
Don't listen to him. He was Mr. Doom and Gloom the entire time you were gone.
Well, I must admit I was a bit concerned.
We were all concerned. Your well-being was a constant source of conversation and speculation.
You see, I told you they'd miss us. So, who won the betting pool?
Morn. He managed to guess the day you'd be back. Only missed the time of your arrival by 2 hours.
He's amazing.
Don't know how he does it.
Mr. Worf.
Captain.
I know what you're going to say. And the answer is yes, I did leave the station without your permission. And yes, I lost a runabout, but...
We'll evaluate your actions later, old man. Right now, I'd like to know everything you learned about this Breen Dominion Alliance.
I am afraid we have very little information to share with you, Captain.
Wayoon and the others were more interested in asking questions than they were answering them.
Why do you think Damar decided to help you escape?
I'm not sure, but I can tell you one thing. He hates Wayoon.
The Cardassians are a proud people, but the Dominion treats them like second-class citizens.
I think Damar is worried that this new alliance with the Breen is going to weaken Cardassia's status with the Dominion even more. But whatever his reasons, we owe him our lives.
Maybe one day you'll be able to return the favor. Doctor, I'd like a complete medical workup on both of them.
Can't tell you how glad I am to see you again. Both of you.
Cura to Sisko.
Oh, go ahead.
We just received a priority one transmission from Starfleet Command. The Breen have attacked Earth.
He is a child.
Miles does have a certain cherubic quality.
I was talking about Dr. Bashir, and you know it. Are you certain he's the one?
I'm not certain about anything. But he is handsome.
You deserve more than handsome. He gets excited playing with toys.
He knows how to have a good time. Besides, it's not exactly a toy. You heard the chief. He spent hours making that.
I see. It is hopeless to try and reason with you.
I know. Maybe I am in love with him. Do you think I should tell him how I feel?
If it will make you happy, yes.
You're a good friend, Worf.
I know. They are wasting their time. No matter how much planning they do, there is no way that they can defend that mission against an enemy that numbers in the thousands. Not without more men.
You know, if you want to go down there and help them. Just a thought.
Miles built this Alamo model, replete with small figures. Quite spectacular, actually. Datasets loaded and verified. Anyway, he was showing it to me in Quarks when we, rather I, accidentally misplaced Colonel Travis.
Laser safety's engaged. Can't you make another one?
What, so he can lose it again? Field stabilizer's online.
Well, that's what happens when you share your toys. Synchronizing warp plasma flow.
It's not a toy. It's a model built to scale.
He really did a fantastic job.
The cell's holding at pre-warp threshold.
Miles, look.
He plays with toys.
It's a model.
With little figures. And in truth, I understand his position. It is the duty of every soldier to support their leaders in time of war. Asking Martok to stand against Gowron was a foolish error.
So what are you going to do?
Try to convince Gowron to discontinue these attacks. You have said very little.
Look, I'm just not sure that I should be giving you advice on what to do in this situation. It's a Klingon matter.
You are still a member of the House of Martok.
This is the first that I've heard of it.
The General and I talked about it weeks ago. He likes you, and he considers you an honorable woman, a worthy successor to Jadzia. And so do I.
That's very sweet of him.
Sweet?
Not a very Klingon word, is it?
No.
It's very honorable.
Better, albeit a little obvious. Now, tell me what you think.
Okay. but I'm not sure you're going to like it.
Tell me.
I think that this situation with Gowron is a symptom of a bigger problem. The Klingon Empire is dying, and I think it deserves to die.
You are right. I do not like it.
Don't get me wrong. I'm very touched that you still consider me to be a member of the House of Martok. But I tend to look at the Empire with a little more skepticism than Curzon or Jadzia did. I see a society that is in deep denial about itself. We're talking about a warrior culture that prides itself on maintaining centuries-old traditions of honor and integrity. But in reality, it's willing to accept corruption at the highest levels.
You are overstating your case.
Am I? Who was the last leader of the High Council that you respected? Has there even been one? And how many times have you had to cover up the crimes of Klingon leaders because you were told that it was for the good of the Empire? I know this sounds harsh, but the truth is, you have been willing to accept a government that you know is corrupt. Gowron is just the latest example. Worf, you are the most honorable and decent man that I've ever met. And if you are willing to tolerate men like Gowron, then what hope is there for the Empire?
So, how's Odo?
Oh, his body shows no signs of the changing disease. I believe he's cured.
Oh, that's great.
Yes, in fact, I'm gonna discharge him this afternoon.
That's really great.
Yeah.
I don't get it. He's interested, she's interested. What's the problem?
He is an overgrown child, and she is very confused.
It could still work.
I guess they worked it out.
You're not the first person to fall in love, you know.
I thought you'd be happy for me.
I am happy for you. We're brought to engineering.
Engineering.
Now try realigning the induction coils.
Will do.
You're sure you're not angry?
Why should I be angry? I have been asking you to tell the doctor how you feel about him for the past month.
Well, now that he knows how I feel.
I am happy for you.
That's a relief.
But I am going to kill him.
You're kidding, right?
And Jadzia said I did not have a sense of humor.
You're coming to Vix tonight, right?
I will be there, but I will not dance.
Who's asking?
Commander Worf.
Captain,
can you spare a moment?
Yes, sir.
We've been discussing your plans for the future.
I was not aware I had any plans.
Commander, how would you feel about being named Federation Ambassador to Kronos?
I am not a diplomat.
And I am not a politician. But sometimes fate plays cruel tricks on us, Worf. Come. Kronos needs you. And what's more, I need you.
You helped him become Chancellor. Can't very well turn your back on him now.
Well, my first loyalty is to you, Captain.
Thank you, Mr. Worf. I'll
probably regret this in the morning, but if it's what you want, then by all means.
It has been a great honor serving with you.
The honor is mine.
I accept.
Excellent. An ambassador who'll go targ hunting with me. Well, perhaps being Chancellor won't be so bad after all.
Congratulations, Worf.